Wow, thanks for coming. So I'm Ken Siegel with Wiz. I think this is the last presentation of the day, so hopefully I'll make it pretty exciting for you, and then we can all go do some fun things. I'm going to talk about strategies for securing your cloud and mitigating potential risks. And really, that means, how do I see what's going on in my cloud, and I can figure out what to focus on, where I've got critical severities, where attackers could actually get into my environment and cause some havoc. I want to figure out how to solve those. Little background on Wiz first. Wiz is just over 2 years old. Already, we're trusted by almost 30% of Fortune 500 companies that are trusting Wiz for their cloud security journey. Some are going on a journey of migrating from on-prem to the cloud, lifting and shifting VMs and resources into the cloud. Others are going on a more modernization journey. They're already in the cloud in VMs, containers. They have Kubernetes environments, and maybe they're modernizing those using serverless functions and other cloud-native application development practices. Wiz monitors over 50 AWS services. We're also deployed in AWS China. We can secure AWS GovCloud as well. While we focus on large enterprises and other verticals, we also can protect environments that are highly regulated. So oil and gas, healthcare, financial services companies rely on Wiz to protect their environments. Wiz is a security competency partner with AWS, and that designation means AWS recognizes our technical expertise and our success with existing customers, joint customers with AWS. We're on the marketplace and available by private offer. Let's get into it. So, how do you prioritize vulnerabilities? The traditional way to prioritize a vulnerability would be by a CVSS score from 0 to 10. And you'd have a cloud resource like an EC2 instance, a virtual machine. You'd have a container. Potentially, that vulnerability would be there. Anyone heard of Log4j? Probably. It was pretty high and wide, very exploitable on a lot of resources. I had a customer that had thousands of resources with Log4j. How did they identify the ones that actually had critical severity risks? How did they focus on those? And we found 30 out of the thousands that they had that had things like public exposure, secrets, admin access into things like storage buckets and databases. It's all of this context across the workload, the cloud, the business context of who owns that application. Is it production? Is it serving customer applications? All of that context is really important to understand. And with Wiz, this is exactly what we do. We take all of that information, provide that context as one notification instead of multiple different alerts on vulnerabilities that could have all different range of CVSS scores, secrets like SSH or cloud access keys, where you're given really no context other than, hey, you have an admin permission associated with a cloud access key. You go find and investigate how to deal with it. These are the things that we want to solve with Wiz. Now, there are really four steps. First step is we want to connect to the environment. A lot of tools use agents. They have a long deployment process. It's very difficult. With Wiz, we're connecting to the clouds with the cloud APIs. By doing that, we're able to set up a connector that has read-only permissions and permissions to take VM snapshots to analyze the VM system disk to see inside workloads, to see applications, misconfigurations, vulnerabilities across the entire full stack of the environment. So a connector for us takes only a few minutes to connect, and then we can start seeing the entire AWS stack, all resources, analyze risks, and focus on risks that matter to prioritize them based on combinations of risk. And then we can start operationalizing. We can automate ways we can remediate those or help our customers to remediate those most critical risks. So I'm going to dive into the first part. When we connect into an AWS account or an AWS org, the API access, we want to have least privileged access, like read-only permissions, the lowest level possible. We still want to have visibility to the entire environment, but we want to make sure that Wiz has very low privileges. We also have the privileges to take a snapshot of EC2 instances, and that's how we're able to see inside those workloads without an agent. And that's critical because that allows us to connect in minutes to the entire AWS organization, all of your AWS accounts, see all of your resources, but the deployment takes only minutes. Once we deploy, the next step for Wiz is to start doing analysis, vulnerability analysis, analyzing the network exposure, looking at public exposure from the internet, looking for misconfigurations in your workloads, misconfigurations in your networks, maybe over-permissive identities and entitlements, looking at secrets like SSH keys, database connection strings that might allow attackers to use those. And what is special about Wiz is everything that we're using to identify this information is being put into the Amazon Neptune database. So all the resources that we have, network resources, identities, roles, workloads like virtual machines, containers, are all in Amazon Neptune. And that allows us to take disparate pieces of information like network and entitlements and vulnerabilities and understand the relationships between them. Once we do that, we can actually understand where the risk is. If I have a complex risk like a virtual machine exposed to the internet, it has a vulnerability that can allow the attacker into the machine, potentially an SSH key or a cloud access key accessing other AWS accounts, I have some impact of exposure. So it's the graph that allows us to understand those relationships. Once we use the graph to prioritize the most critical risks, then we're doing this analysis, effectively looking at the network of, you may have cloud configurations of a virtual machine exposed through an internet gateway, or exposed through CloudFront, or a load balancer. Wiz does all of the work to understand exactly how things are exposed. You may have containers exposed through a Kubernetes cluster, which has its own network configuration. And we need to layer on Kubernetes network information with the cloud information, cloud network configuration, so we understand effective exposure. We take into account all routing rules, any service control permissions, any network policies that would grant or restrict access to those resources, exactly how the attacker sees it. The next thing we do is the same thing for identities. If we want to see from a virtual machine or a container that has access to storage or a SQL database, we want to understand that effective exposure. So we take into account all the analysis of the identity, the entitlement that gives access, so we understand what the attack path, what the risk is, and the impact of that. When we put those together, we can start with a real-world example. In the bottom, I have in blue, those are my workloads in the graph. These workloads are running Linux. It's unpatched. It has many vulnerabilities. It allows the attacker to gain access. The problem is now it's exposed to the internet. If it wasn't exposed to the internet, maybe it would be a lower risk. But because we can see exposure through CloudFront and an internet gateway, I know that it's exposed and the vulnerability allows the attacker into the VM. I also know that maybe there's a misconfiguration. Maybe all access should go through CloudFront, not the internet gateway. So it's very easy to identify potential misconfigurations in the network because we know exactly how things are connected. The other piece of information we collected is there's a private key that exists inside that workload on the disk of that machine. This private key, we don't just tell you, hey, there are private keys in your environment because everyone has private keys and you do the investigation. We're going to do that for you. We're going to figure out what public keys are associated with the private key. We'll go find those public keys on every resource in your AWS environment or other clouds and tell you what the lateral movement path looks like. So now I can see I've got public exposure to a VM that's vulnerable, a private key that gets access to another machine that has access to a database. This is how most breaches happen, is there's indirect exposure to a database. The database or the storage bucket is not exposed directly to the internet. There's no access point directly. But through indirect exposure is how it's affected. And Wiz is able to uncover that, all with setting up a connector that takes only a few minutes. We do this analysis across all of your clouds on a daily basis, so we see all risks on a regular basis. Now, the fourth step is once we identify those risks in the cloud environment, how do we enable teams to act on those? I get the question pretty regularly of, can you remediate? How do you remediate? Because that's really the concern, is that now that I have this issue, I've been able to focus on the risk, what do I do next? With Wiz, we integrate with dozens of products. Most commonly is to integrate with Jira to create a ticket. If I see a critical issue, we can immediately create a ticket in Jira, deliver it to the right team so they can fix their issue. DevOps application owners can also access Wiz so they can see their own issues, act on them, and we know that it's resolved. in addition to looking at the cloud estate, we also want to protect earlier in the lifecycle. So when there's a build process where a virtual machine image or a container image is being created, or infrastructure as code where you might have a Terraform plan or a CloudFormation template, Helm chart, we want to analyze using the same policies we do with a cloud estate. We want to do that in that build pipeline. So we can fail the build or notify if we find vulnerabilities or secrets or misconfigurations that shouldn't get into your cloud. So not only can we identify the most severe cloud risks in your cloud estate that are already running and remediate those, we can go back into the build process before those risks even get into the cloud. Now, I know this is a pretty quick discussion about Wiz. If you do have additional questions about how Wiz works, or if you'd like to see a live demo, I'd love to have you come over to booth 507. We'll have a couple of solutions engineers over there as well, where we can actually walk you through how Wiz gets connected to an environment in a few minutes and connect, actually see the entire visibility of all resources and focus on those risks and remediate those. Thanks very much.